everyone back to channel. Now let us see the overview of cell injury. Actually, what is cell injury? When cells are stressed so severely that they're not able to adapt anymore. So we know cellular adaptation. So whenever the cell can't undergo any adaptation, so it is like a almost frustrated stage to the cell, then it is nothing but causing the cell injury. So it is of reversible type and irreversible type, we all know. So reversible means, as its name says, it's mild form, so it can be easily reversible. And the main hallmarks are important here, that is decrease in the oxidative phosphorylation. That is, we know the oxidative phosphorylation takes place in the mitochondria. So when oxidative phosphorylation takes place, the ATP decreases, of course, because this takes place to form ATP only. So when ATP is decreasing, the cellular swelling takes place. Why it takes place? Because when the ATP is decreased, the sodium potassium pump gets damaged. So when sodium, actually, what is the function of sodium potassium pump? It is that the sodium should be taken out of the cell in exchange of calcium and potassium. But here, because of this ATP damage, the sodium potassium pump damages and leading to accumulation of sodium inside the cell. So when the sodium is accumulated inside the cell, you know, always water follows the sodium. So here water also accumulates along with the sodium. This is leading to the cellular swelling. So due to the change of the ionic concentration, that is nothing but the because of the pump, and this is leading into water influx, and the intracellular organelles show variations, because you know, as water has come inside, there are variations in different organelles like cytoskeleton and also mitochondria. But let us see the irreversible and cell death. So what is it? It can't bear stress anymore. So reversible injuries, okay, it has a mild form of stress, but irreversible injuries like so much stress, so it can't bear it anymore, and it is divided into, we know, necrosis and apoptosis. Necrosis is like murder and apoptosis is like suicide. And lysosomes destroy the cell and cellular contents leak out, resulting the necrosis. And next, when cells DNA or proteins damage beyond the limit, they undergo the suicide, that is nothing but apoptosis by the nuclear dissolution. And next, the fragmentation of the cell without complete loss of membrane integrity. So only the cells inside structures are fragmented, but the membrane is still normal, and the rapid removal of the cellular debris. So the necrosis is always a pathological process, but the apoptosis is also for normal functions. It is not especially for cell death, but the necrosis is always pathological process. And the cell death is an end result of autophagy. So what is autophagy? It is nothing but eating of own cells. So whenever in starvation, as all nutrients are decreased, our cell eats our own cell. So this is autophagy. So cell death is an end result of autophagy too. So this is the overview of cell injury.